Hi friends, welcome back to the Pragmatic Lopa. What else can you ask for more in your busy hectic schedule to be able to eat healthy and delicious each and every day just within minutes? So in our second part of quinoa, I'll be showing you how you can cook it the perfect way every single time. But I'll be showing you two different basic ways of cooking. You can opt whichever way suits you the best. If you haven't checked out the part 1, stop right away and go through its health benefits first to appreciate its importance for including it in your diet. The link will be provided in the description box.
Quinoa is extremely quick and easy to make. That is why it can be an ideal choice for anyone. You can store the dry quinoa in any airtight container, preferably glass, and keep it in a dry, cool place. You can store it for months together, and if you want, you can keep it in the fridge as well to keep it fresh for long duration.
You can cook quinoa on any weekend and store it up in an airtight container and pop it in the fridge and use it for major days of the week, that is 3 to 4 days. If you want it for a week, you can store it in the freezer, but when it can be cooked within minutes, why to store it for such long duration? It's a good option for sprouting as well, which would increase its nutritive value fourfold, which would take 3 to 4 days depending on the climatic conditions.
It's known as the most versatile food. You can blend it with any food of your preference in number of different ways. Any of your favorite recipes, you name it, you can add quinoa into, in soups, salads, wraps, even as desserts, or on its own with your favorite spices, and enjoy it whenever you like, may it be breakfast, lunch, dinner, or for snacks.
As I have already mentioned in part 1, quinoa contains phytic acid, which binds minerals present in quinoa like magnesium, potassium, zinc and iron, which prevents absorption of these minerals by the body. So by sprouting or soaking before cooking, phytic acids get reduced, hence improves the bioavailability of the minerals so that nutrients get optimally absorbed by the body.
That's why I recommend to soak quinoa at least for 5 minutes, if not more. Rub the seeds well with your fingers while soaking so that the undesirable water-soluble natural plant residue that coats the seeds, called saponin, can get washed off, which would otherwise contribute to the bitterness of quinoa. No matter it's organic or mentioned pre-wash, don't skip on this step. Now thoroughly rinse under cold running water for the impurities or any residue remaining and strain it using a fine mesh strainer. As the seeds have the tendency to absorb lot of water, make sure you drain all the water. Keep it in the strainer for a while or use a paper towel to absorb excess water. The best part is it's cooked the same way as rice, so you don't need to be skilled at cooking if you're new to quinoa. Only difference is it takes half the time as rice. You can even cook it in a rice cooker. For cooking, the ratio is 1:1.5. That is, for 1 cup of quinoa, you'll need 1.5 cup of water. Some prefer it 1:2, but I like it 1:1.5, as this way it won't be mushy because of excess water, but instead would stay separate and fluffy each and every time. Just like rice, it also triples in size, so 1 cup of dry quinoa will give you 3 cups of cooked quinoa. In the first one, for 1 cup of quinoa, place a medium saucepan over high heat and add 1.5 cup of water. Bring it to a boil. Now add the strained quinoa into water and give it a good stir with a spoon. Now cover the lid and lower the heat to minimum and cook the grains for exactly 15 minutes. Once the time's up, Turn off the heat, but don't uncover the saucepan. Let the quinoa rest on the burner for another 4 minutes before removing the lid. This will allow any residual moisture to be absorbed. Simply remove the lid. Now that the quinoa is cooked to perfection, don't forget to fluff it with a fork to keep it that way. When it's done, quinoa gonna look translucent and a little white germ will wrap around each seed like this. In the second one, I'll be toasting quinoa and add healthy spices to give flavor to it, that is turmeric and black pepper. For 1 cup of quinoa, place a medium saucepan over medium heat. Once hot, add 1/2 teaspoon of any oil of your preference, as sesame oil or coconut oil. Now add strained quinoa into it and toast a little bit over medium heat for about 1 to 2 minutes till you hear gentle pop-up sounds and it gives out a subtle nutty aroma. This is known as toasting of quinoa, which gives it a delicious roasted flavor. Keep stirring. Now add 1/2 teaspoon turmeric and allow quinoa to absorb the spice, and add 1/2 cup of water. Turn the heat to medium high to bring it to a boil. Give it a little stir. Now add 1/2 teaspoon salt and 1/4 teaspoon pepper. You can make it salt free, but do add pepper. It will add its flavor to quinoa that would complement turmeric. Mix them well. Once it starts boiling, pop on the lid and bring down the heat to low so that everything is simmering, and cook for exactly 15 minutes. Then turn it off and let it sit unstuffed for 4 minutes like the first one to absorb any residual moisture. Remove the lid and remember to fluff it with a fork. In both the ways, once cooked, transfer the cooked quinoa into a dish and spread it to allow it to cool at the same time to avoid any further cooking. You can eat it cold or hot. You can also use vegetable or chicken broth or stock to cook quinoa for extra added flavor.
Hope this video was helpful. So make sure quinoa is a regular and a must addition to your diet. There are many healthy and delicious recipes on quinoa coming up on my channel, both for vegetarians and non-vegetarians. So stay tuned. Thank you for watching. Until next time, take care. See you again.